Alessandra, a PhD student from the Clock Group at INL. Clock stands for Quantum and Linear Optical Computation, and I am working with quantum computing. This is a very broad topic, so what am I doing exactly? Well, that's what I'll be trying to explain over the next 150 seconds. I am interested in quantum algorithms, which exploit quantum mechanical effects for computational benefit. You have probably heard of Schrödinger's cat, a cat which is both dead and alive, representing a quantum phenomenon called superposition. Only when you observe the system does it collapse onto a specific state. Our cat is either safe and sound, or it dies for good. Now, let's say that we have many, many cats, and we know that one of them is dead, and we want to find this dead cat. While this may seem like a straightforward task, it can be pretty hard. It may be easy to tell a dead cat apart from a live one, but not necessarily to find it in the middle of such a large crowd. Now, the standard strategy would be to nudge the cats one by one, checking each of them to see whether they're alive. In the average case, this would mean checking one half of the cats. This is the best we can hope for, classically. As it turns out, we can do better using some quantum tricks. The idea is to rely on quantum superposition and interference to amplify the dead cat, so that when you observe the clouder, we are especially likely to find it. This amplification process requires only the ability to recognize dead cats and to perform some standard quantum operations, and it's also performed quadratically faster than any classical approach. This is called quantum searching, and is quite interesting by itself, but I'm interested in something a little different. Let's say for simplicity that we now have two cats, one of which is dead, one of which is alive. And now we don't want to find the dead cat, we want to assess its relative size. Again, amplification comes in handy, though for a different reason. It allows us to observe the cats under different conditions, which is more informative than always looking at the same thing. This task is called quantum amplitude estimation. Apart from feline wellness checks, it has many important applications in science and engineering. And it has also been shown to enjoy a quadratic quantum speedup, just like quantum searching. However, the quantum devices of today have been unable to realize this potential due to hardware limitations. In particular, they suffer from limited coherence, which sort of means that our cat gradually vanishes as it is amplified. As such, researchers have been actively trying to find algorithms for quantum amplitude estimation that are more forgiving towards experimental shortcomings while still offering a quantum advantage. And that is my line of work.